Part 4, Farmer Son Preppin. Camp out, September 26, 22. Setting up the tent. Right, where's my door? Here's the door. All right. Get out of the way, chair. Y'all, excuse my old wore-out shorts. We poor folks around here. And you know men, they wear clothes till it basically falls off. You know, that's the way it is in the South anyway. Where's the pole, Vic? Always good to practice setting up your tent or your hammock, whatever it is. Even if you have to do it in your backyard sometimes, it's good to know how to get it up in a hurry, you know. It's good to know how to put it up, is what I'm saying. Don't have to be no timed event or nothing. I went and put a knot in that booger for some reason. There we go. Yeehaw. Tent poles. If you've never put a tent together before, it can seem a little overwhelming at first. You know, just think it through. Do one thing at a time. It ain't gonna be no 30-second install on these tents. It usually takes me about 8 or 10 minutes to put mine up. Alright, there's one rod put together. Get out of that bush. Basically, you're just gonna make an X over the tent. And that's kind of where they're gonna go. So for you who have never camped, who have never put a tent together before, there ain't really any instructions, or at least not on my cheapo tents. So you may just have to take your time, figure it out. And that one's all together. note the shape on each one of these. Each one of these poles has a shape on it. Some are round, some are squared off. Both of these actually are squared off on the top. Sorry, buddy. Let's see, before I do that, don't get ahead of yourself. I'm known to do that myself, get too far ahead. These, there's some slots I find kind of slide through. Oh, Jesus. Where, here we go. Here's the first slot. To the other one that's going to come across the center on the top, and you find your other one that coincides with it. Start running your rods through. They will get hung up from time to time. Every time. Let's get you over here. Oh, that's the worst. When the rods come apart inside the sleeve, that sucks. Push them all through. Come on, what's holding me? On some of your older tents, the little threads that hold the poles together will break sometimes. You just kind of try to keep the pole together while you're sliding through the sleeves here. Whatever. All right. We're going to get this one in the end here. There. Get up off my lazy bones here. That's fine. I'm just trying to get this first one on. Alright. That one is on. Next pole, the same thing. Just run it through both the sleeves. And then we stand her all up. Sleeves are orange on this tent, which makes them easy to find. Alright. There's there's a little loop here on the center. I'm gonna run this one through the loop. I mean, it's there. Might as well use it. Alright. Get in this other sleeve right here. Alright. This is the most difficult part of putting up a regular dome tent. It's just dealing with these rods and sleeves. But you know, there's way more different types of tents out there besides just your old dome tent. This is like a $38 Walmart special right here. These poles are about 12 feet long. So it takes some doing to get them around through the sleeves. If y'all can even hear me, I don't even know if y'all can hear me from over there. There we go. Now we're looking like something. Get this pole on this end right here. Ow, guys. The middle part of the tent has clips. You clip onto the poles, which gives you more room on the inside of the tent. Clip this one. Let me, maybe y'all can see how I'm doing it. Just clip it on. Clip it on. Other than the stakes, basically that's all it is for setting up a tent. Alright, where's my stakes at? Most tents are going to come with these cheesy metal stakes, you know. I've lost two of these somewhere, but I've got extras in my go bag if I need it. This tent also comes with another pole that goes over the top and stretches the tent out even more like that, but I normally don't even put it on. I'll normally just leave it aside, put it back in the pole bag. Alright, dude. Always leave your sleeve on your hatchet when you're hammering. No need in having it off unless you're splitting wood or something. Safety first. There's a ring on the bottom. You're just simply gonna put your stake through that ring. All right, get out of my. That's good. Basically, just the four corners. if you're worried about wind, you could do more stake, depending on your campsite location and all that. We're in kind of a thicket, but then a little opening in the side of a thicket here, so not really too much worried about wind. All right, y'all, I'm gonna hammer the rest of these stakes, and we'll get with you next time on the next little whatever.